Hello and welcome back to Control Structures. This is our last little segment of our introduction to PHP. So as I've been saying, PHP is heavily influenced by the C language. And so the logical operators are pretty much taken straight from the C language: double equals, not equals, less than, greater than, less than or equal to. Double ampersand is and, so that's and, or, and then exclamation point is not. The, of course, assignments like $x equals 4, that's the assignment. So single equals assignment and double equals is the question. It's asking the question, is answer 42 without changing 42? And, of course, the classic problem is only putting a single equal sign here, which turns this into an assignment statement but not a syntax error, so avoid that. We use curly braces to indicate the beginning and end. If then else, you have to put parentheses for those of you coming from Python. The other thing from Python is or, and not are the logical operators, and we have these sort of short versions of them. And so Python just uses words for those, and that's actually something that messes me up when I'm going back and forth between C-based languages and Python. Whitespace does not matter, like all C-inspired languages, so these two things are completely equivalent, except that your friends will not like you if you write code like this. And so we are very disciplined in our coding to put indents and, so that you can easily match things up so you know where blocks start and stop. So all those Python indentation techniques that you learned hold you in good stead. It just doesn't cause syntax errors if you use a tab instead of a space, although you want to still be consistent in your tabs and spaces. There's a number of different coding styles for C-style languages. There is sort of the original coding style, which we call the Kernighan and Ritchie. I call it Kernighan and Ritchie for the original white and blue textbook that was written when C was introduced in the 70s. It's the language what I learned it from. It's a beautiful, thin book. I like my books to be thin. And K&R is a more compact. And what they do is we put the starting brace on the same as the if, and then we put the ending brace to line up with the if, and then we put the new starting brace on top of the else, and then the ending brace ends up. And this is good for if you were typing cards, which I actually never coded C on cards. I did code Fortran on cards, but not C. And cards, or if you had a really tiny terminal, and sometimes you do. And so this is a more compact. A more expansive for younger people who think that screens are all gigantic, tends to like the idea of lining up the curly braces. I can't argue that one of these is somehow better than the other. I personally prefer this. I prefer the compact because I want to see as much concept on the screen as I can, even if my screen is large. And the other thing I don't like about this is it turns this simple else concept into three lines. But if you run into an organization, and in the Sakai project that I work on, we have a million lines of code, and some code is this way, and some code is this way, and you just accept it. You should learn to read both styles, and you should learn to write both styles, and don't argue. It's perfectly okay to have a personal preference, and it's perfectly okay for that personal preference to be different than other people's personal preference. That's my personal preference. That's okay. It's fine. So a multi-way branch like most languages, in that it basically is checking the ifs one at a time, and the moment that something becomes true, it executes that code block, and it doesn't come back and doesn't check any of those other things. It doesn't even check them. So if more than one of these is true, only the first one that's true is going to trigger. And so we construct them very carefully in the order, especially if you put more than one else if. The order matters because you don't know which order they're going to be. I mean, you know that you. It's not like PHP looks at all of them simultaneously. It literally sequentially checks, then it checks again, then it checks again, and so away you go. And so that's how the multi-way and its else if concatenated, but really else if is its own keyword, basically. If you have only one statement, and statements, of course, in PHP are ended with a semicolon. If you have one statement, you can leave off the curly braces. These two things are equivalent. I would probably never do this else if. Neither of these are particularly good code style. I mean, I'm just showing you because you can do it. I tend to only allow myself to use the if on the same line if it's really short and this is short and I don't want it to go long, if I have to spread it across two lines, I always put curly braces on it. And so again, you're just trying to make life easy for the person who's reading your code. And 99 times out of 100, the person reading your code trying to figure out what you're doing is yourself, or maybe someone trying to help you. So we should put a lot of energy into making our code readable. In terms of looping structures, there is a top-tested while loop where it's asking a question, and it's a zero-trip loop in that it functions the first time when it first encounters it. It really functions kind of like an if statement, and if this is false, it skips completely, which means it never, it potentially, if the statement is false, it won't execute the loop body even once. In a sec, we'll see a one-trip loop, minimum one trip. So it functions as an if statement. This particular loop is bad because it's an infinite loop, infinity, meaning that it's going to run forever because this is going to stay true. Fuel is greater than one and we're not doing anything to fuel, so we make an infinite loop, which is going to run out your battery or crash your computer or who knows what. And so that's like a badly structured loop. With a while loop, you have got to do something that has to do with your iteration variable. And so in this case, it's going to run until this, you know, true, false, and then it's going to get out and finish the loop because we are modifying the iteration variable as we are progressing through the loop. And so with a while loop, we'll also see in a bit how you use a break that gets out of the loop. So you have got to manage the exit from the loop. If you don't, it's not going to be all that smart for you. There is in PHP a one-trip loop. It's rarely used, but I'll just cover it here just so you kind of know it. I don't think I've written a one-trip loop, a do-while loop in... I'm not sure I can recall when I used one of these things. But the difference is it's got a do at the top and it's got the test at the bottom. And so it's a one-trip loop, which means it doesn't check the question that's down here at the bottom that's true or false until it has made it through the loop once. And so that's why it's a one-trip loop. So even if this is false, the first time through, it has executed the loop before it even knows that it's false. Now, here we are using in this, it's going to, you know, we are doing, again, we have to manage the iteration variable. And this is a situation where I'm using the pre-increment. And so if dollar count has in it a 4, well, let's make it be a 2. Let me clear this and do that again. So if the count variable has a 2 in it, it comes in and it adds 1 to count. That's what the plus count means. And then it takes this 3 and it participates in the less than or equal to 5, which in this case is going to be true. So it's going to go up and run the loop again. When this loop becomes, when this comes in and count is 4, and it comes in here, it adds 1 to it, and then the 5 participates in it, and so then that becomes a false, and then the loop finishes. So it just kind of comes down here. Now, when we start looking at break and continue and the ways we can sort of bump, well, actually continue, it turns out that it's important that we use this post-increment or pre-increment in this particular thing, because if you continue, you want to make sure that the iteration variable is updated. And so there, again, I tell you not to use these things, but this is a canonical place that we tend to use these. And then this is a counted loop. And so this is a for loop. This is a weird little syntax. It's got parentheses and it's got colons. And I remember when I first saw this, it seemed super crude, but after a while, you just kind of get used to it. You just have to remember that the first part before the first semicolon is what runs before the loop starts. It's like helping you construct a while loop, basically. Before the loop starts, it initializes the precondition for the loop. Then it's like a top-tested, the second piece is a top-tested question that is, as long as it's true, the loop is going to continue. And if it's false before the loop starts, it's a zero-trip loop. And then count plus plus is the thing we do at the end of each iteration or before the beginning of the next iteration. And this, of course, is a good place where we do use the plus plus. If you said count equals count plus one here, they'd be like, oh boy, you apparently didn't get the memo, because we always say this. And we've said this since the 1970s when we first started using C. And so that basically is going to run this, and it's going to start count from one, and count is going to go, and when count is 6, this is true, so it runs one more time when it's 6, but then count becomes 7, and this becomes false, and then it skips out. So that's a counted loop. And so it's pretty elegant. You just construct a counted loop. You create a variable that is your iteration variable. You initialize it in the first part. You check its ending value in the second part, and you make sure that you add 1 or subtract 1 or whatever it is that you need to do for your loop. There is a for each loop, which we'll see in the next section. We talk about arrays that is a non-counted loop that goes through, you know, all the items of things. That's a very nice loop, but sometimes you do need a counted loop. So like most C-based languages or C-inspired languages, we have a break, and break is an executable statement that basically says when this runs, it breaks the loop that it's in. If there's a couple of loops that are sort of a loop inside of a loop inside of a loop, and there's a break inside this, it actually only breaks out of the inner loop. It doesn't break all the way out to the outer loop, and so it's the innermost loop. In this case, I've only got one loop, so it is the only loop. If this code executes, it's like magic jump and gets out and runs, jumps to the line afterwards. It basically says, we're done with this loop, leave. Now all the other iterations have run, and then so it, when it would come down and say count 5, this becomes true, so the break happens, and it just does done, even though it would have run until 600, if we'd have just left it to its own devices. So that's, again, people might say this is not structured programming. I hope among decent people we've stopped arguing about that. I'm sure at some coffee shop somewhere they're going to argue about whether or not this is structured programming, whatever. This is really, it gets to code that is direct and easily understood. Continue is to, it doesn't exit the loop, it exits the current iteration of the loop. And so it says, okay, I'm not going to finish this iteration, but I'm not going to stop the loop. I'm going to go right to the next thing. And what's important is that when the continue goes up, it runs the third piece in this case. And that's why back in that while loop, if you do a continue, you have to put the increment in the while bit because you want to make sure your iteration variable moves ahead. That's why we tend to use instead of do whiles or while do's for counted loops, we tend to use for loops for counted loops because the continue works perfectly and the loop continues. And so if this is basically saying if it's even, the divide by 2, look at the remainder, continue. So it's going to run this 10 times, but it's only going to run this 5 times on the odd ones, count 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So the even ones ran, they just ran the continue. So it just went up. And so it didn't print this. That didn't happen on the even iterations through the loop. And so that's a quick summary of zooming through PHP. We will next talk about arrays and other aspects of PHP. This is really just the core language.